Hi and welcome. So in this tutorial, what I'm going to do is just quickly run through the process of modeling up this piggy bank in Blender and exporting it as an SDL file for upload onto Shapeways. So let's get started. Okay, so first off, I'm going to come up here to File, User Preferences, and I'm just going to enable some add-ons that we're going to need. Okay, so I'm just going to scroll down here and just quickly take a look. Okay, this one here, definitely STL format, so we can export to Shapeways. Just put a check mark if you want to enable that. Okay, just come down here a little bit more. Definitely have loop tools, the mesh option here enabled, and just keep coming down, I think, and this one here. So shortcut keys, very important to have that one done. And I think that's more or less it for the add-ons. If you just come up to inputs, I'll be using left select with the mouse button. Okay, Blender's default is right, and that can be quite confusing. Also, just going to put a check mark beside emulate numpad. That way you can use the numbers across the top of your keyboard to switch between the different views. All right, and next is the interface. Zoom to mouse position. Okay, that just saves you having to pan and zoom, etc. And rotate around selection. Those two important ones there. Okay, with that done, you can just save user settings and X that down. Okay, I'm just going to press delete and delete that cube. Shift A, and I'm going to add a UV sphere. Just going to come over here to the tool shelf for the initial options, and I'm just going to increase this to 64. Okay, it'll help smooth it a small bit. Okay, I want to rotate this on the X by 90, so RX. Okay, so after the add-ons are done, the next thing I want to do is come over to the scene tab and just set up the measurements. And for this one, I'm going to be using metric. So under the length in the units area, I'm just going to set this to metric. I'm just going to press N for the properties shelf, and we can come up the top here. Just take a look. So the UV sphere is selected. It's 2 meters by 2 meters by 2 meters. Okay, so if we take a look at Shapeways, the rules under bounding box. So for porcelain ceramic, it's 125 by 125 by 200 millimeters. Okay, so we need to have it a little bit smaller than this. Okay, so I might go for 120 by 120. Okay, and you can have a look at that there. So it's important to have a quick read of their guidelines before you start modeling, just to make sure you're keeping in line with it. Okay, so like I said, 125 is the maximum. So we're going to have to scale this down a little bit. So I'm just going to press S and scale this down. Okay, so 120 or thereabouts. Okay, that's a rough approximation. So I'm just going to tab into edit mode and switch to face selection. Just going to come over here. Just press A to deselect. Just going to press C and just select all of this area here. Okay, I'm just going to press E, extrude this out a little bit. Okay, maybe just pull it back in slightly. I'm just going to switch to edge selection. Just going to alt select this here and control B. Just add a bevel and just smoothen that off a little bit. Just going to press 7, come into top view, switch back to face selection. Just going to select some faces here to form the ears. Maybe 8 each side, something like this. Okay, and I'm just going to press E and extrude these up. What I'm going to do is come over to the modifiers tab and just add a subdivision surface and just leave it at 1. Switch on this option here, the adjust edit cage. All right, so we can see it in edit mode. I'm going to press the full stop and select individual origins and just scale this on the X. These faces here. Okay, something like this. And I might just scale them in Y, maybe a little bit more, and maybe just drag it forward. Maybe just press 3 and maybe rotate this slightly. Okay, I'm gonna press 3 again and press 5 for orthographic. I'm just going to press Z and come into wireframe. Just press A to deselect, and I'm just gonna box select everything in the second half and just press G, press Y to restrict it to the Y axis, just to give them a little bit of depth. I'm going to press Control 7 for the bottom. Just press A, come back to solid. And I want to select some areas that we can extrude down for his legs. So maybe select something like this. And the same on the far side. Okay, and the same on the back here, maybe something like this. Okay, I'm just going to press 1 and take a look and see, do I have what I want selected? And I might just deselect these and these ones and just come in underneath a little bit more. Okay, and just press E. Let's press 1, drag this down. I'm just going to scale this on the Z by 0. I'm just going to press the full stop and come back to medium point and scale this on the X just to scale his legs in a little bit. Come back to individual origins and scale on the X, to scale them out slightly. And what I could do is Control R on each foot here and just put an edge loop and drag it down to the bottom just to give a flat edge or a flat face on the bottom so he can stand. Control R, drop that down, something like this. Okay, if I come around to the back here, I'm just gonna switch to vertex selection and select this, Control Plus. Okay, I'm gonna press E, I'll just scale this down. Okay, press E again, can maybe press 3, come into side view, and I can maybe just rotate this, come up, just rotate a little bit more. Okay, something like this, maybe just press G, don't have it so long. Again, we have to remember that the wall has to have integrity, so we don't want this piece falling off or causing us problems. So again, just press 3, I might just rotate this back a little bit, maybe scale it up slightly, just Control Plus, scale that up a little bit. Okay, I'm just going to put the views up to 2. Just to have a look at that. Just going to tab back to object mode and hit the smooth shading. Okay, now press 7, top view. It's going to come up here and make a slit in the top. So I'm going to switch to face selection. Select maybe these 4 faces. Okay, something like this. Okay, and actually one, if I come up here to file user preferences and add-ons, just make sure that measure it is enabled. Okay, just save the user settings. And it's going to switch to vertex. Just going to select this point and come up here to the measure it tab and just select segment. Okay, and just hit show and we can see it's, so if I come over here to this here, just expand this a small bit, switch this to mil, so it's 50 mil. So is that long enough for a coin? Probably not. So I'm going to have to go a little bit longer. So maybe from here to here and again, segment. Just come back over to this one and delete the first one. So 73 is probably long enough for a coin. Maybe we don't need to go as long. I'm just going to X that. So maybe from here to here, check the segment, 60 mil. I think that's going to be long enough for any coins in Europe. Okay, just going to switch to face selection. I'm just going to select these ones here and now I can hide the measurements and hit delete and select faces. Okay, and it's probably a little bit too wide. I'm going to switch back to vertex selection and just get a length on this. Just get a segment on that one. And so that is 11 point. Okay, that's probably wide enough for an opening. Maybe a little bit too wide. Just going to hide that again. Can switch off, select all of these and just scale them in the X a small bit. Something like that. Okay, just going to add another modifier. This time it's going to be a solidify modifier. And what we need to do is just going to come back up the top here. Going to come back to object mode very quickly. We have some transformations we need to apply. So we have a rotation of 90 and in the X, and we have a rotation of negative 0 in the Y. We also have a scale that's non-uniform and needs to be applied. So Control A, I'm going to choose rotation and scale. Okay. And now you can see that the modifier is a little bit too big on it. So if I come over to the modifier, the solidify modifier, and maybe put in 6 millimeters, that gives us probably a good thickness there. Okay, and we're getting a small bit of artifacts on the ears. So I'm just going to tab into edit mode, switch to face selection, and maybe select these 4, just drag them forward slightly. So we're out of that. Okay, and you could select individual vertices here and just edit your ears, make them look a little bit more realistic, but I'm not going to spend too much time on this. Okay, so that's the basic form of my piggy bank. So I'm just going to just press A once or twice and switch back to face selection. Okay, I'm going to switch to wireframe. I'm going to come down here to select. What I want to do is see, do we have an issue with any of the geometry on our mesh? So the way to do that is select by trait. Now we're looking for non-manifold and it's not listed here. And it's not listed here because we have face selected. So if I switch to vertex selection, so Control Tab, switch to vertex, and make sure everything is deselected. If I come down here to select by trait, you see now that we have non-manifold. So I'm going to select that. Okay, and you can see now that it's telling us we have a issue with this section. So I'm just going to press Z and come back to solid. Okay, it's basically telling us we have a hole here. And what we need to do is apply this solidify modifier. All right, and because it's second in the stack, so I'm just going to tab back to object mode. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the solidify up top and see, do we have any issues? Okay, so we have the solidify up top. That looks okay. And I don't want to apply the subdivision in case I want to make any changes later. So what I'm going to do is just apply the solidify when it's number one in the stack here. Okay, so if we tab back to edit mode and just press A to deselect, and what I might do is just again come into wireframe, make sure I'm on vertex selection. Okay, come down here to select all by trait non-manifold. Okay, and if you have a look up here, there's zero issues with vertices, there's zero issues with edges, and there's zero issues with faces. So our model is waterproof and good to go for 3D printing. Okay, I'm just going to come back to solid, and when you're happy with your object, I'm going to tab to object mode. The location, the rotation, and the scale are all applied. Just one little issue. If we take a look at the dimensions, it's a little bit too big for the maximum bounding box on Shapeways. So I'm just going to press S and Z to scale it in the Z direction. So I'm just going to come down to maybe 1.4, something like this. Okay. And you can notice now that we need to apply the scale. So Control A and rotation and scale. And I'm going to leave the subdivision as is. We can export it without the need to apply it. So I'm just going to come up here to File, Export, and this one here, STL. Okay. And so select that. Selection only. Okay. You can also leave apply modifiers, so it should apply the subdivision surface as it's exporting it. All right, and I'm going to leave the default forward and Z up. Okay, again, pick a location for your SDL file and export SDL. Okay, so if we open up Shapeways, I'm going to just select upload and select it. So it's piggybank.stl, select open. I'm going to leave millimeters checked and hit the upload. Okay, when it comes in, there's going to be issues. I'm just going to select scale, and instead of inches, I'm going to come to meters. Okay, and save. I'm also just going to look and check the porcelain. So when that comes in, you can see that it's passed all the Shapeways tests. Okay, so it's good for all of these porcelain colors. And if I just come up here to this tab, you can have a preview, see what it's going to look like. So you could buy it and do some painting. So maybe paint in some eyes and some detail, etc. Okay, so that's basically it. If you have any issues with your model, you can always come back to Blender, update it. And again, you can keep the subdivision as it is and just export it, upload it to Shapeways again, and see how it's looking. Okay, and actually, just on Shapeways, you will have to create an account, but it's a free account, but it's a very cool service. Okay, so that's going to do it for this one. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.